The deployment phase takes place after each round is over. Each deck has 5 heroes, and when the game starts, the first 3 in your deck are distributed to each respective lane in a random order, along with 3 melee creeps, distributed randomly as well. After the first round completes, your 4th hero in the deck is able to be spawned to a lane of your choice. And finally, after the next round, your 5th hero will get the same treatment. Every deployment phase thereafter, you will get 2 melee creeps to fight for your side. You do not control those. They will spawn in a random lane, but you'll clearly see where they're going ahead of time. You'll also see what lane the enemy creeps are going to, but you will not be able to see where their heroes are headed until you've both locked in your choice. Keep in mind that despite knowing what lanes the creeps will go to, you don't know what position within the lane quite yet. That's where arrows come into play. Once you've chosen a lane for each hero to deploy, you'll notice arrows start to pop up in the lanes. By default, units will attack straight ahead, but there's a chance an arrow can redirect your attack. Something to keep in mind is that if there's nothing to redirect to, then the arrow is just removed. In this first lane, you can see 3 arrows placed. Both Mazzy and the far left creep will hit straight ahead. The creep next to Lycan, however, has been redirected to hit the creep on its left. In the third lane, you have 2 right arrows being placed. The first is the melee creep being redirected towards Enchantress. The other is Lycan being redirected to nothing, which of course means that arrow is removed, and he will instead attack straight ahead. Be sure to click the annotation on the screen for the next tutorial. Thanks for watching and subscribing to Artifact Cinema. Be sure to click that bell icon in order to get notified when we put up a new spotlight or guide.